Hello and welcome to today's broadcast. Today we're talking with two members from ACP staff to talk a little bit about our accomplishments in 2023. I'm Rich Comitz, Chief of Staff here at ACP, Chief Operating Officer at ACP. And I'm really excited to be able to share a little bit about what we're about and what we've been doing. For those of you who don't know, ACP is now 15 years old. We've experienced a lot of growth over the years, and it's great because every number that we increase, it's helping another member of the military community. To set the stage, to give a little background, ACP now has about 70 employees. Most of those employees are working with our proteges and our mentors, making those mentorships happen and facilitating them as they go. We also have plenty of people that are working in other areas to try to get the word out about ACP and grow ACP more. Those 70 employees are spread out amongst our New York City office, our DC office, and we also have about almost 20 remote employees as well. We're very proud that the majority of the remote people are military spouses and or have served themselves. We're organized into some teams that compose some of the operations associates, but they also work in these different business areas. So today we're going to talk through some of those areas and some of our the impact that we've had over 2023. If you have any questions, please drop them in the chat and we'll get to them a little bit later in the broadcast. Also, this will be recorded and remain on our LinkedIn. So if you want to take a look at it again or share it with anybody, please do. Another thing I get to do today is introduce Megan and Jennifer. They're going to help me at hosting some of this year's webinars, so you'll get to see a little bit more of them. So I'm really excited to introduce them today as well. So let's meet them. Megan, why don't you introduce yourself?
Sure. Thanks, Rich. And I'm honored to be able to start hosting soon. I'm very excited. I'm VP of Corporate Relations. I oversee the Corporate Relations team and our corporate partners. I have close to 15 years of consultative sales experience working with companies of all sizes, and seven of those years were focused on tech. I also understand the importance of mentorship, as I've had many mentors myself. I have two currently, even throughout my career, they've been so valuable. And without those mentors, I really wouldn't be where I am today at ACP. I value it, and I understand the gaps that our military personnel are facing and our military community. I'm really grateful that I get to work for a company that is really doing such an amazing job of filling those gaps. And the mission is so special to me. So, it's I'm happy to be here, and I'm really excited to be able to host some of the webinars going forward.
It's great. It's great having you on the team. You've hit the ground running, and it's been super exciting to see you operate here at ACP. Thanks. Jennifer, tell us about yourself.
Sure, I'd love to. Thanks, Rich. So I'm Jennifer Williams. A lot of people know me as JR. I will answer to either name. I'm not picky. But I'm the communications manager here at ACP. I came here after I served 22 and a half years in the Army. I was in public affairs. And I actually am also a very proud ACP alumna. So I like to tell people, you know, I don't just work here. I was also a protege myself. So really, my experience as a protege within the program is what really motivated me to work here, to apply and get a job. And really, it's my mission now to make sure that all transitioning service members, veterans, military spouses have the same incredible experience that I had. The mentorships are impactful. They're life-changing. It's not just for me, but it's also helped my family as well. And so just really excited to be a part of ACP, share what we do, and really looking forward to hosting some of these webinars so you can get to know more of our partners and what we do here.
Oh, great. Thanks, Jennifer. And the amount of support and growth that we've seen in the area of communications and social media has been amazing since you've been on the team. So thank you for that. So I want to start today's kind of session talking about the heart of ACP, which is the mentorships. So last year, we actually had more applications than we ever had before to our mentorships. So that's really amazing. I think that's an indication, we'll talk about this a little bit more, that the word's getting out a little bit more about ACP, that people are sharing the fun or success or good opportunities with their mentors, and they're willing to pass it on and show other people. So that's been amazing to see. And then last year we had a record number of alumni. So alumni are those that have finished the 12-month process. And that was 4,465 alumni that finished last year. And we're currently helping around almost 5,000 proteges at this time. So they will continue on and hopefully be alumni this year as well. And although we're not a job placement firm, we do try to spend a lot of time connecting people with that are looking for jobs, with people that are looking to hire veterans and military spouses. So last year, over 2,682 proteges got jobs while in their mentorships. Now, not everybody's ready to get a job while they're in their mentorship, and sometimes people get them after the mentorship, but we're over half, almost two thirds got jobs while in their mentorship. So we're really proud of that. Again, this is a testament to the mentorships, to the right connections being made, and then the mentors kind of going out of their way, helping the proteges get where they need to go. And last statistic about the program in general that I'm super proud of is that we surpassed 30,000 alumni this year. So, or last year in 2023. So that means 30,000 people have been impacted by a mentor through ACP. So we're super excited about that. And we are happy to be able to do that for more, 30,000 more in the next few years. Hopefully that'll be less than 15 years. But so Megan, I'm going to turn to you and ask you to talk a little bit about corporate relations, our corporate partnerships, and how that goes and what we've done in that area this year.
Sure. 30,000, that's a big number. I'm excited to be a part of that growth. Corporate partners are growing. In 2023, we added 12 new partners, over 1,300 new corporate partner mentors, and over 1,600 corporate partner mentors participated for the second time or more. We also have over 130 total partners, and 118 of those are part of our corporate partnership umbrella. All this growth means that, you know, our corporate relations team is growing. We have 11 corporate relations associates that are on my team. They help manage the day-to-day and help foster the relationships with our corporate partners. A really amazing team. They're passionate about the mission. Very lucky to have them. Talented group of individuals that really take their goal and their day-to-day work seriously.
Yeah, and another thing I think maybe you can talk quickly about is when we have people come to us looking to join as corporate partners or get more information, I think that's another area that we work on as well.
Yes, definitely. It's the biggest thing we're working on.
Mm-hmm. We'll get people that'll inquire or people that'll get a job somewhere, a protege that'll say, hey, I want to get my company involved. And Megan and her team also will reach out to them and, facilitate the introductions and see if we can get them to come on and be a corporate partner. We're really thankful for the number of corporate partners we have. The people are amazing. The mentors are always going above and beyond, and we really appreciate that. All right, so let's talk about, we just kind of talked about where the mentors come from, but Jennifer, let's talk about where the proteges come from, because without proteges, we wouldn't have a program.
No, that's very true. And I would say that is the incredible work of our outreach team led by our vice president of outreach, Leslie Coffey. And if you've ever met her or seen her on one of our webinars or with one of our partners, you know how committed and dedicated she is to the military community. So this past year, we had a record number of applications, almost a 10% application increase from the year prior, which is incredible. And then, of course, members of our outreach team attended over 500 virtual and in-person events to talk with members of the military community, explain what ACP is all about, kind of connect them to our program. So it's just an easy find, like you're not hunting around for us. They pretty much guide you right there. And I really think that part of that is just the results, right? So we have proteges, they come through the program, they have this incredible experience and just the impact that they've experienced, they recommend it to their friends, they recommend it to family members. And I think that really kind of speaks to you know, the efforts of outreach. It's one thing to talk about it, but when someone has experienced what it's like to go through a program, when they have the care, the attention, it makes a difference, and then it makes it easier to, you know, tell everyone else to join us.
Yeah, I definitely agree with that. And, you know, the other thing about our amazing outreach team that I learned is that, you know, when you think that you have this great program in ACP, you just want to tell everybody, and there is no one mechanism. Like, we can't go to the Department of Defense and say, tell everybody about ACP, and they say, okay, and then they tell everybody about ACP. So we have a lot of challenges with getting the word out about ACP. So the word of mouth, as you mentioned, is super huge. So if you're out there listening and you know of anybody that can be helped by ACP, please spread the word. But the other thing about that is, you know, as you mentioned, over 500 events that they've attended. Leslie and the team are always trying to talk to new groups of people about who we are, what we do, and how they can benefit from it. So it is a lot of work to get the word out, and they're always trying to engage new groups of people to let them know about ACP. So we can use everyone's help out there as well.
And I would also say partnerships. I mean, really, our outreach team has really made the most of our partnerships. We have so many incredible partners, and it's just, you know, the proof is that when we all work together, we drive positive outcomes for the military community. And I think that was also another factor there.
Yeah, that's a great point. We, you know, we work with a lot of different veteran service organizations. There's a lot out there, and it's not, you know, we don't see it as a competition. Right. If anybody can help, just as long as someone's helping that veteran or military spouse, we're happy. And so we have a lot of partnerships where, you know, we refer people to them for what services they're better at. And then they refer people to us for the mentorship program. So we really appreciate all of our other veteran service organizations. So shout out to all them that are out there that are helping us. I think we'll get to see some of them this year on some webinars too, sharing some of the things that they're doing and we're doing together. So something we started doing a little bit more this year than we have in the past is talk a little bit about fundraising. And we've recently had a member of our team join us, Deidre, and she is in charge of philanthropy and has kind of organized some fundraising efforts. Because, you know, at the end of the day, it takes money to run this organization, but we offer this service free to the protégés. So we have to find ways other than just our corporate partners to fund our program. And so we've been doing some fundraising. I know people have different opinions about fundraising, but at the end of the day, any dollar that we raise, it goes right back into helping another service member or their family. So we really appreciate it. So Megan, can you kind of highlight some of the initiatives we did last year with fundraising?
Yeah, definitely. We work, my team works pretty closely with the fundraising team. Deidre's amazing. She's rolled out some exciting new initiatives to assist, to your point, Rich, outside of just getting the funding from our corporate partners. One of the initiatives was the Army-Navy Challenge that took place in the fall. That was 251 new mentorships. And 182 donors made their first gift during Army Navy. So a lot of success there. And we will roll that out again in the fall. So those that are watching, please look out for that. We had a great event with it.
Well, I think she froze on my screen. She's frozen for everyone else. Oh. All right, Megan, we'll let you come back. But yeah, I think she was finishing up in saying that you know, it was a good initiative last year. It's something new to our team and our community that we're working on. And again, thank you for those that donated. And we're really, the money goes right back into the program. So if you feel that you can help in that way, every dollar counts. So thank you for that. And thank you to the fundraising team for ACP for, you know, continuing to steward some of that and work on that project. All right. Now, another thing that I'm pretty excited about, because I think this is the best way to get the word out to our population, because really our society is really geared towards the digital world. So as I mentioned before, when Jennifer came on and we also had another person come on at the same time, Tabitha, who were both very instrumental in growing our social media following and getting the word out and making the impact of social media resonate through our community. So Jennifer, let's talk a little bit about some of the things that you're proud of about the digital communication areas that we've grown in.
Yes, my pleasure, Rich. Well, one, we gained over 19,000 new followers. So that's pretty credible number just to have, you know, people feel strongly enough that they wanted to follow us and find out what we're doing. And that, of course, led to over 1.5 million impressions, which is very exciting. We also have a newsletter. And this past year, we tried something new. So instead of just sending it out through our, you know, through email, we also created a LinkedIn version. So that way, you know, you can read it however you prefer, right? So that led to a 27% increase in readership, which means that we're sharing information that people want, right? So they're coming back for it. And then last but not least, you know, kind of my pride and joy is our LinkedIn group, ACP Connects, which we grew by 10,474 new members in 2023 alone. And currently we have over 19,000. So it's just incredible. And if you are not familiar with our LinkedIn group, ACP Connects, you can search for it. You can request to join. And what's kind of unique about the group is that it's designed to share resources. So if our partners have open roles that they'd like to share, any, you know, jobs where they would like to hire military, they're sharing them in the group. If they have a VRG and you want to learn a little bit more about a company, that's where you go. We have resources for, you know, people are sharing their internships, their skill bridge programs, even just fun things for the family that are free to partake in. People are sharing them in the group. It's very active, and it's just been exciting to see you know, people come to it and exchange ideas and information, and people have found jobs that are great opportunities. So I'm really proud of that.
Yeah, I definitely agree. I love seeing the interactions in ACP Connects. And there's actually a question in the chat about someone that is a pre-9/11 service. And so I know that we work towards mentors with pairing people with mentors that have served since 9/11. So if you're pre-9/11, ACP Connects is a good place to get information and ask some questions and get some mentorship kind of through that network of people. So I would encourage those of you that are pre-9/11 to take a look at that as well and join. I'm also super excited about the amount of traction we got on our main LinkedIn page with celebrating people that are getting jobs, our corporate partners, our mentors. So yeah, if you're out there and you haven't looked at our LinkedIn in a while, definitely take a look at it. A lot of great news, and you can get an idea of how we're working and how we're making an impact almost on a daily basis. Also, that's a good place to find out what's going on in the community, not only our community, or not only with us particularly, but outside us in the community. So we advertise some really good of our partners' webinars and other things that they have going on. So definitely take a look at that. And speaking of kind of continuing on that, one of the things that we did, you know, it's been about a year now that we moved our webinars like this onto LinkedIn Live, and we've been really successful there at reaching a lot more people. So I'm super excited about that. I do love posting and talking to people. So Jennifer, can you talk to us a little bit more about that impact?
No, absolutely. Our LinkedIn Lives, well, first of all, we hosted 4 symposiums, and we know that people enjoy them because we had so much response to them. People joined us live, they watched the recording many times, and it's just a great way to kind of share information, especially during the transition process when you're trying to figure out how to stand out as a candidate, when you're trying to figure out how to translate your skills into a company. Our webinars are probably the perfect way to do that, because we get the subject matter experts who tell you very explicitly, like, hey, this is what we need from you for you to be successful at our company. It's gonna be incredibly helpful. And then just in the last year, we had, you know, over almost 76,000 total views of all of our webinar content. And then this year we're changing things up slightly by changing the time to 12:30 to better accommodate schedules. And then also bringing more of our partners to talk about, you know, ways to make the most of your transition. And if you have already transitioned, as I was in that boat, and you're not sure what to do, how to get forward, move forward in your career and progress, these webinars are an excellent tool. So even if you're a veteran or for an alumni and you've landed that great job and now you want to progress, our webinars are really, you know, structured to help you figure out how to make the most and how to move forward.
Oh, that's great. Yeah, I'm super excited. I really think people get a lot out of the live streams. There's a lot of great conversations on there. And some kind of getting your foot in the door in a lot of places, too. A lot of our corporate partners will offer, very specific ways to get in front of hiring managers. So really excited. And if you haven't taken a look at too many of these, I think you should. So Megan, maybe you could talk a little bit about some of the things we have kind of in the future coming up. But we really just kind of started really kind of fostering our alumni network a little bit. And we also are, you know, slowly thinking about this a small business initiative. So you want to just talk really quickly about at least the alumni stuff?
Sure. First, I do want to say that I can vouch for Jennifer and Rich, the use of our ACP Connects and webinars. Our corporate partners love to leverage both of those. I always enjoy seeing them post. They love to post new jobs. They're also very excited to do a webinar when they can. So it's both of those things are great tools, and I love seeing them at work. So alumni, kind of piggybacking on something you said earlier, Rich, about our proteges that get jobs through our corporate partners. We also love to see them return as mentors. So we've kind of had to shift our focus and really focused on our alumni group. And we created an alumni network. It's an initiative that we started in 2023. Thus far, we've had 594 alumni return as a mentor. Really excited to see that success and see how it grows further in the upcoming years. We understand that the help shouldn't stop after the mentorship or 12-month journey through our program. So we formed a team that is focusing on more ways we can help our alumni with growth and development after they leave the program. It's important for them to be able to grow within the careers that they choose. And whether it's through our corporate partner or not, we want to be able to see them continue to grow and develop and kind of shifting some of our focus there is really important, and we're excited to see the success that we've seen so far.
Yeah, I think, I kind of want to say stay tuned, right? We're going to continue to bring more kind of resources and focus some of our webinars and some content on, you know, maybe people that want to better themselves in their current job or consider, career moves or things of that nature. Also, we're excited that our proteges and our alumni can send in their resume quarterly. They get an email that we collect the resumes and share them with our corporate partners that are looking to hire people from the military community. So that's another good way to leverage the alumni network. But there'll be more coming, so keep an eye out for that. Also, keep your eye out for a small business initiative. We're looking to get into helping people that want to start small businesses in a little bit more of a deliberate manner. So keep your eye out for that as well. So I think that kind of covers most of the major accomplishments we've had last year. But one thing I want to just talk about briefly is our team. I'm super proud of our team. Every one of them are passionate about helping people and go above and beyond to give people the white glove service. And again, I can't say how proud I am of our team. We have about 70 people, all of them doing an amazing job managing upwards of 100 pairs of mentor and proteges, as well as helping Jennifer in communications and Megan manage corporate partnerships and Leslie and Deidre with outreach and fundraising. So really, the team is quite amazing. I really, really love it. We have Joe that's behind the scenes and Casey of all of our LinkedIn Lives, making it easier for us to do these and present these to you. And then we have Kayla and Brandon usually in the chat that are providing resources. So a shout out to all of them. We we really have a great group of people that is really passionate about helping, and it makes it easier to come to work every day for sure. Other things I'd like to say is that, I mean, I love seeing, and maybe Jennifer, if as I'm talking, if you can think about a story or two, but I love seeing the good news feedback that we get from our proteges and our mentors on a daily basis. I mean, most recently I saw a Major League Baseball mentor who, you know, was working with someone that wanted to, that was in, I think, physician assistant school or studying to be a physical therapist or something to that effect. And they not only were helping them with those decisions of schooling and all that stuff, but they invited them to the Pittsburgh Pirates and to their facilities and said, hey, why you want to do this? Why don't you talk to people that are actually doing it? So they brought them behind the scenes, and they were able to actually see what goes on in a sports program such as Major League Baseball, and how they might be able to get a job and work in there, which, I mean, I love seeing those stories and hearing that. So Jennifer, I know you are collecting a lot of these good news stories. Anything come to mind that you're super excited about sharing?
Well, there's several things, honestly. What the best part of my job, honestly, is that we have so many proteges and mentors who are very gracious about sharing their experience, sharing their story. And it's always, it's very moving, honestly. Like they touch my heart, and it's, you know, sometimes, you know, each mentorship is very unique. So the goal, the outcomes are going to be different for everyone. And just the fact that someone will come to us thinking there's no way you're ever going to find a person who can help me reach this very specific, unique dream. And then it happens, like to hear that, like, oh my goodness, I never thought I'd be able to do this, and I'm doing it. Those are the stories that just really move me. Or, you know, what a lot of people may not know is that a mentor can be a great resource during military transition, not to deal with just professional goals, but also challenges. Like, our mentors have been able to step in during very challenging times, provide solutions or ideas that help our proteges kind of get over, you know, some of these bumps in the road, and you know, go on to have a very, very bright start to their civilian careers. So, you know, whether it's, you know, someone who did one, you know, one term of service, and they're coming out and they're just not sure how to translate what they've done into what they want to do. And a mentor helps them figure out, like, not just like a, you know, help them focus, but helps them, they sign up for the right school, right? So they're getting the right degree that's going to help them leverage that education into a great career. It's the mentors who help the, you know, our military spouses who had a career gap and not sure how to address it, and help them not even just address it, but like really get where they need to go. So we have so many stories like that, and we wouldn't have them if they weren't so willing to share them. So for everyone that I've reached out to in the past year and you've agreed to share your story, thank you. I can't tell you how much it means to me.
Yeah, and I've heard people say that, you know, these mentorships has not either changed their life or saved their life, right? And you know, you and I, definitely having served, know that when you leave the military community, there's kind of a big void. And if you fill that with negativity and some bad luck, you can really be in a bad place. And having a mentor kind of help you through that and being your cheerleader and helping you get on track definitely can really change someone's life. So we really appreciate that. Megan, I was thinking recently, yesterday we had a pretty nice event happen where one of our corporate partners brought us an additional donation, right? And I don't know if you want to briefly talk about that. I have some, you know, we have some great team members that are doing great things and fostering those relationships. And I just thought it was a good example.
Yeah, it was a donation, $100,000 that was outside of the funding for our corporate partners. Completely unexpected. It was something that they did internally. We love to hear that, hear our corporate partners going above and beyond to help drive our mission forward. And everybody was extremely excited. The morale was very high when we received that. And it was great to see the corporate partner come to our office and hand deliver it. It was a special moment for everyone.
Yeah. And, you know, I'll tell you, I was in that conversation and the point of contact that we spoke to said that, you know, they have done this fundraising type of thing in the past and have donated to other organizations, but they decided to donate to us because of the interactions that we've had, the impact that they've seen, and the positive experiences their employees have, and the relationship that they have with their operations associate in the corporate relations area. I throw out his name, James. Shout out to James for that particular one. But I was thinking about this yesterday, and almost every one of our corporate partner operations associates and managers have had some great victories this year, whether it be a corporate partner increasing their donation because of the great experience that they've had, a corporate partner, you know, going above and beyond and getting us more mentors and asking to get more engaged. Every one of the team has contributed that way. We recently had one of our corporate partners that have been giving us a longer term donation to extend it another year without even really asking. And again, I think that those are really a testament to our the work that we're doing and the employees that we have. So if I haven't said it enough, I'm really proud of this team. I really love what we do here. And I'd ask anybody out there to go ahead and spread the word. And I'd have to say, also, I want to throw up a comment from Leslie. We were speaking about her before, but she definitely said, hey, I love my team. They're so dedicated to our mission serving. And that's great. She has people presenting to different groups of people all the time. So we really love it. Any parting thoughts from either of you? I'm super excited about 2024. I think we're going to break some records again.
Yeah, I'm excited as well. I just wanted to add that, you know, the extra funding goes a long way. It helps us fund more mentorships. We've had a huge influx in veteran and spouse applications in the past month, close to 2,000. So again, it's just, we appreciate every little bit that we get, especially, you know, when the corporate partners go above and beyond it helps.
And I guess all I just have to say is that I am, like you, very excited for 2024. We have a lot of momentum coming into the new year. And just, you know, I feel like this year we're really going to embrace all of our partners, our proteges, our mentors, share even more incredible stories. And just as a gentle reminder, next week we will have our newsletter coming out. So check it out. There's a mentorship success story that I think you'd really want to read and find out about the impact we truly make.
Great. Thank you. And for everyone out there that's watching, if you know someone that can benefit from an ACP mentorship, please don't hesitate to refer them our way. If you are in a position to be a mentor, you know, go ahead and sign up. All this can be done on our webpage at acp-usa.org. Also, finally, if you are in the position you'd like to donate to the cause, we'd be happy. As Megan said, every dollar that we bring in is helping someone in our community, giving us the ability to, you know, provide one more mentorship. So thank you, everybody, and hope you have a great day. And here's to 2024.
Thanks so much.
Thank you.